Santiago, and for today's video, I'll be doing a tier list of all the anime that I saw in 2022, and I compiled it all into this tier list, and it's about 60 anime on here. Actually, I think it's exactly 60, so this is going to be a long video, and we have a lot to cover, so I'm just going to go over quickly the tiers I've made. So Masterpiece are the ones I think are some of the best anime that I will ever see in my lifetime. It's up there with the best of the best, my favorites of all time. S tier are ones I still think are top quality, the ones that are very good that I'll still remember. A tier are still pretty good anime that I would still recommend that people would watch. B is solid, you know, for a seasonal anime, it was a solid entry. I enjoyed it. I didn't think it was bad by any means. It was solid. C is a little below average. I still think it was an okay anime, but it's not one that I necessarily would recommend to people. And then D tier is the lowest of the low, the ones that I don't necessarily recommend to people. Someone may like it, but for me, I think it's the worst of the seasonal anime. So we have a lot to do, so let's just get started right into it. So the first one is Aharen. And Aharen is sort of like Komi-san. Aharen is very antisocial, and she can really only communicate through whispering. And I thought this was a really cute anime. I love the relationship between her and the main guy character. And even though it was a bit episodic, I thought there still was a good story to it and building up their relationship and chemistry. I'll put it in a B tier for now. I think this is a good spot for it. Next one on here is Akiba Maid War. This may be the wildest, craziest anime that I have seen this year. Judging just off of episode 1, you would see what I mean. And this anime just continues every episode building on that and just being absolutely insane. This is an insane concept, start to finish. I do think, though, like, none of the characters are really gravitating towards me. It's definitely between A or B, but I'm going to put in B for now. It might make it up to A by the end of this list. I might reconsider, but I'm going to put in B. Next one on here is Ashi. Ashi is a soccer anime and one that came out in the spring, and I really like Ashi. I think it has perfect vibes. I think it's very motivational. None of the characters, again, is one that none of the characters really stood out, but every episode I thought was really well done. I think they did an amazing job with the series, and I'm going to put it in A tier. Very liked it. Next one, Attack on Titan, Final Season Part 2. I'm a huge Attack on Titan fan. It's one of my all-time favorite series. And this is actually my second favorite season of all time in Attack on Titan. Favorite season is Attack on Titan Season 3 Part 2. I think this is the second best. This is a masterpiece, without a doubt. Next one is Birdie Wing, A Golf Girl's Story. I actually watched this and quite enjoyed it. I was not expecting to like it as much as I did, as I didn't see the ratings or reviews were that good, but this was wildly entertaining, very unrealistic, but it's essentially just mafia meets golf. Like, they have its own underground, like, organization dealing with the golfing and also betting, and it's actually really ridiculous and over the top, but very enjoyable. This is another B tier, I'd say. This is one that is very solid and one that I think there's going to be a season 2 coming next year, which I definitely would watch. Now, the next one on here is Bleach, Thousand Year Blood War. And this is one that I know many people are very excited for, and me included. I still like Bleach, and I think this is actually better than what I was expecting. The animation and the studio did an amazing job with it. As of now, it's an A tier for me, but I can definitely see it moving up to S eventually. Next one is Blue Lock. This is another soccer anime, and one that I also really like. I think this concept for this sports anime is actually kind of genius. They added a lot of psychological stuff to it, and it's not all about the teamwork that every other sports anime is. It's about building up your individual self, which is a different message in all together. And I also really like the characters in this one. Bachira, Chigiri, Rin, and Nagi are my personal favorites. This is a good anime, even though I will say the CGI is horrible. They use some CGI in some of the matches, and it looks really out of place. So I think that knocks it back just a little bit for me. It's between S or A, and I think I'll give it A for now. I might move it up. Next one on here is Bocchi The Rock. Bocchi The Rock came out this season, and it is awesome. This is probably the most creative anime I've seen this year. I think the studio behind it just put so much passion and creativity into the series. It's probably the most enjoyable series I've seen this season right now. I'm loving every episode of it. I think it continually gets better and better. This may shock some people. This is a masterpiece. I absolutely love Bocchi. It's reminding me a lot of the Ranking of Kings vibes that I got from last year, which is my favorite anime. I love Bocchi the Rock. Next one is Call of the Night. Call of the Night is immaculate vibes. This is a series that the vibes and the music is the plus for me. I love this series for that. The romance between, I'm blanking on the character's name, Izana, that might be wrong completely, but her and the main character, I thought it was okay. I thought she did a really good job. I thought her character was really interesting, but the romance part was, I didn't think it was that strong of an element, I'll be honest, but the music and the vibes is awesome. I'm going to give it an A tier. This is a good anime. Next one on here is Case Study of Vanitas Season 2. Now, I read the manga for this. I saw Season 1, and Season 2 also was awesome. I feel like it's very underlooked nowadays. I think a lot of people actually kind of forgot that this came out, but Tiago did not. I remembered this. I watched it. I loved it. Vanitas is an amazing character, super entertaining, one of the best of the year for sure. I'm going to put in A. I think his character is awesome. Next one, man, we're getting a lot of heavy hitters right off the bat. We have Chainsaw Man next. Chainsaw Man was probably the most anticipated anime in my lifetime that I could remember. His Attack on Titan, I'll say this, new anime in my lifetime, not sequel. Because Attack on Titan, actually, I'd say probably was the most anticipated every season of that, huge expectations. But this, everybody was expecting this to be amazing, and it delivered beyond what I could expect. The animation, the studio put so much into this anime to make it look amazing, to make the endings, the openings, the characters, the fluidity of the action scenes, everything was perfect. This is an easy masterpiece. I loved this anime, and I'm looking forward to everything that they do because the manga is very interesting, so looking forward to it. Next one's Chimimo, and Chimimo, I only saw one episode of. So this one's a bit tough to rank. I mean, it has to be one of the lower ones because it didn't pursue my interest. So it's either a C or a D. But I don't think it's worthy of the D, I will say. I think the D is the lowest of the low. And I could see some people enjoying this. I'll put it in C, actually. Because, honestly, the first episode wasn't terrible. But maybe if I continued it, it would definitely be in D tier, maybe. Who knows? I'll put it in C, though. Next one on here is Classroom of the Elite Season 2. Classroom of the Elite Season 2 continued. I cannot believe it actually came out. Season 1 came out, I believe, 10 years ago? Maybe 8? Something like that. It's ridiculous. And I'm so happy that Season 2 came out. I really liked Season 2. Kiyotaka is an awesome main character and really carries this series. But also the antagonist, Ryusui? Gosh, I'm blanking on some character names. It's late for me. I'm sorry. But he was very good. I mean, this Classroom Elite's great. I'm looking forward to another season. This is another A-tier. Another A-tier sequel. Next one is Cyberpunk Edgerunners. This one I didn't have much expectations for. I actually completely forgot it came out. And Trigger did a really good job with this one. I think they knocked it out of the park, honestly, for a video game adaptation. For a video game that also heavily disappointed many people with everything that came out with it. But the anime was really good. Really liked the characters. Really liked the story. Pacing was excellent. I'm going to put it in S tier. This is not a masterpiece for me, but this is definitely worthy of S tier for me. Next one is Demon Girl Next Door Season 2. I actually caught up on this earlier this year. Watched Season 1 and watched Season 2. I think this is a solid anime. I think it's a B tier. Next one is Demon Slayer, the Entertainment District arc. Now, a lot of people hate on Demon Slayer. And I understand why there's a lot of hate. I think the characters are a little overrated. There's really not much to the story. But with all that said, the animation's amazing. The fights are phenomenal. Ufo Table really does an amazing job elevating its source material. And with Demon Slayer, Ufotable did an amazing job. Ufotable is what carries this anime, not its content itself. Ufotable makes everything look amazing, and they honestly did an amazing job with this. The fights are awesome, the animation's awesome, and they did a really good job. This is an S tier. All right, next one. The Devil is a Part-Timer Season 2. Why did I think of Demon? I'm so sorry. Devil is a Part-Timer Season 2. Again, it's late. I apologize. This is one I was actually really, really anticipating. Devil is a Part-Timer Season 1. If I was just like putting it on this tier list in itself, it would probably be an S tier for me. I really love it. And so my expectations for it were S. After the first episode, I was like, oh, it's probably going to be an A. And then the series went on. And I think I'm going to give it C tier. It honestly could be a D. Because it was that bad and disappointing. But there were still some redeemable elements. So I'll give it C. I won't give it the D tier that it probably does deserve. Next one is Dr. Stone Ryusui. This was awesome. It was a 45-minute bridge to season 3. And they did a phenomenal job. Just from the opening alone, I feel like this deserves praise. They redid Good Morning World with a new rendition. Their new rendition is amazing. And also, Ryusui as a character is great. I'm so excited for season 3. This is an A tier. Really like this one. Next one is Engage Kiss. Engage Kiss I dropped, I think, after 2 or 3 episodes. Did not pique my interest. This is the first D. Simple as that. Next one, Executioner and Her Way of Life. So Executioner, A Way of Life, off the concept alone in the first 2 episodes, I would have put it probably like A tier. I really enjoyed this, but that concept they completely abandoned after the second episode, and it just got too ridiculous for me. They should have stuck with the original concept. They tried then forcing a romance between the main character and this other character, which I didn't care for, and then they threw in this random final boss, essentially. I have more complaints about this, but really, I loved the concept of this, and it just really disappointed me that they didn't stick with the concept, which was essentially anyone who got isekai to this world, they get hunted down, and they literally stopped doing that after episode 2. This is a D tier. Next one is Futo PI. This is a Kamen Rider show, and I didn't know that going in, but I really enjoyed this. I think the mystery elements were really good, that the main two characters, their dynamic was really cool and really well done, especially after episode 1, after arc 1, because they sort of set up that their dynamic, they're a bit at odds and opposites, but it really came along really well. This is a good anime. This is a B. Next one, Genius Prince Guide to Rebuilding a Kingdom. This one was solid. Main character I thought was really solid, and also his strategy in many of the episodes was entertaining because he's essentially not trying to help the kingdom in some ways. This is a C tier though. This one's definitely one I would probably forget. Next one, Golden Kamuy Season 4. Golden Kamuy is one that I think is another underlooked, underrated anime series, and Season 4 has been awesome so far. I think Season 3 and Season 4 have been the best seasons so far in my opinion. It is airing right now, so it's still going, but right now it is an A tier. They moved off from the CGI bear. Alright, the next one is a villainous anime. It's So I'm a Villainous and I'm Taming the Final Boss. It's something like that. This one's actually really funny. I need to catch up on this series, but from the episodes I have seen of this, it's really funny. The dynamic between her and the final boss villain character is really good. And I really enjoy this. This is another isekai villainous anime, and this is one that's solid. This is a B tier. All right, the next one. This is another time I'm going to butcher because it's such a long title. But essentially, I raised my farming skills and got stronger. It's something along those lines. And honestly, I think I need to make a row below. And this is for farming poop. This series stinks. This is the worst anime I've seen this year, by far. This anime, I weirdly had some expectations for. I thought it would be at least somewhat entertaining, but this anime sucks. It has maybe the worst CGI model of a dragon that I've ever seen, and I thought Fate Stay Nights was bad. This anime is so bad. The opening's not even good. Nothing really is redeemable about this anime. It's just, honestly, it's horrible. So no one watch it. Next one is I'm quitting heroing. And this is actually one that's solid. This is another concept one that I thought was really interesting and really good. Off episode one, the concept of this main character being done being the hero, and he wants to join the side of the villains and help them out, even though he essentially screwed them over. But now he wants to help them out, and they all hate him. This is one that, again, the concept was good, but as the series went on, I lost some interest in it, especially towards the end of the last few episodes I thought wasn't the biggest fan of. But there were some good twists, good moments, good humor, but it was solid. I'll give it a C tier. C or B for sure. Next one is JoJo's Bizarre Adventure Part 6 Stone Ocean. This one I read the manga for, so this I already knew was one of my least favorite of the JoJo parts so far. But I don't know, I expected at least a little bit better so far. It's still JoJo's. I still really enjoy it. But for JoJo standards, it's one of the weaker parts. But for a JoJo weaker part, it's still an A tier. But for JoJo's, like, JoJo's Part 4 and Part 5 are easy masterpiece for me. But JoJo's Part 6, I'd say, is A. Also, the opening is one of the weaker JoJo openings. JoJo openings are awesome, usually. Next one, Jujutsu Kaisen Zero, the movie. Awesome. Jujutsu Kaisen's great. Gojo's amazing. This movie is awesome, telling the story of Yuta. This was really, really well done. This is an S tier. Now, speaking of well done, Kaguya-sama Season 3. This is actually my favorite season of Kaguya-sama, as it is, I think, for many people. And this is what elevated it to one of my favorite anime, actually, of the last few years, I would say. Kaguya-sama Love is War is peak comedy. The characters are amazing, especially all five. All five of the main characters are great. This is really tough. It's the closest thing to masterpiece, but I'm going to put it S tier. I really want to put it masterpiece, but I want to reserve the masterpiece spots. So I'll put it in S tier, but it is awesome. So as everyone already knows, it is, because everyone's seen it. It's one of the most popular anime of the year and of the last few years. So you are expecting that. But one that some people may not be expecting is Kingdom Season 4. Now, I'm a huge fan of the Kingdom manga, and the Kingdom anime has gotten a lot of hate. And I understand why. Season 1, the animation is horrible. It's honestly horrific. It's up there with Berserk for terrible animation. But the animation gets better after Season 1. Season 2 is solid, and then Season 3 and 4, honestly, I really like the art style. And Season 4 covered a great arc in the series. This one may shock you, but it's an S tier. Kingdom anime is actually really good. Looking forward to Season 5. Next one, Komi-san, Season 2. Komi-san's always been one that I think is alright. I think the animation is really unique, though, how it animates Komi. Also, there's a character I absolutely hate, like hate in this series. It's the girl that has that obsession with Komi, and I cannot stand her every time she's on screen. So I think even because of that, she's the anime's B tier. I can't put it higher just because of that one character. That character is horrible. But Komi overall, the series is overall, it's solid. Next one is Love After World Domination. Love After World Domination really caught me off guard. It's essentially a Romeo and Juliet spin-off, but with heroes and villains, and it's actually really good. I really like the characters in this. I think the comedy works very well. It's very entertaining, very easily binged. I think I binged in like two days, maybe. I really like this anime. This is one I will remember from this year. This is an A tier. Another one I will remember is Licorice Recoil, which came out in the summer. Licorice Recoil, I really enjoyed. A1 did an amazing job with the series. Chisato is awesome. The animation in terms of the gunplay is really cool. Towards the end, though, I think it started dipping a little bit for me, but I think it's still an A tier. This is still a good anime. I bet many would probably expect it to be S or masterpiece, maybe even S, but I think A is still a solid spot. But speaking of masterpiece, Made in Abyss Season 2, this is without a doubt a masterpiece. The music, the score, the characters, the dark fantasy elements of it all, Faputa, the backstory of it all, so damn good. Made in Abyss has honestly blown my expectations out of the water. I read the manga for this. The manga is amazing as well. But my goodness, the anime really delivered. The adaptation is amazing. The music is phenomenal. I love Main Abyss. It's one of my favorite anime of all time. And season two really delivered. Easily a masterpiece. Next one is Mob Psycho 100 Season 3. Mob Psycho 100 Season 3 is what I expected also Main Abyss Season 2 to be. I expected to fall in love with this because I didn't know, actually, that there was more to the story. And honestly, I still love it, but not as much as the first two seasons. This is one that I don't want to say I'm disappointed in because I still really like it, but it's an S tier for me. I really want it to be a masterpiece because Mob Psycho 100 is one of my all-time favorite anime. But I don't know. I think it's too slice of lifey right now. And there was an arc that really felt really out of place where they meet aliens. It was really weird and out of place. And I think for that, it's S tier. Compared to the first two seasons where I feel like every episode just lent more and more to Mob and also the story and characters. And I don't know, this season there's a few elements that just aren't doing it for me. But still Mob Psycho 100, I still love it. The animation's amazing. Reagan and Mob are awesome characters. This is still an S tier, but I really want it to be a masterpiece. Okay, still have a solid amount to go. Let's go. My Dress Up Darling. So this one got a lot of hype, and it took me a while to watch it, and I finally did. And I still like this anime. I think Marin is still a good character, but I think this is still a little overrated for me. But I do think the romance elements of it are solid and still entertaining, but I'm going to put in B tier. This anime is just, I don't think I was the right demographic for this. Next one is Overlord 4. Now, Overlord has always been a series I feel like I've been a little critical of. It's always been an isekai I've always thought it was a little overrated. I liked season one a lot. Season two, I wasn't the biggest fan of. Wasn't a fan of the lizard people. And season three was solid. But I honestly think this has been the best season. Overlord 4 was really solid. It really tied a lot of story arcs together. And I think this is actually an A tier. Next one is Parallel World Pharmacy. Now, Parallel World Pharmacy was a solid isekai. But there's not much else to it. I think it was very solid, very enjoyable. I liked the main character, and it felt unique. This is a B tier, I'd say. I enjoyed this. Wow, this is really top heavy so far. Okay. Next one is Police in a Pod. Police in a Pod is a series I didn't finish. I actually ended up dropping it, but not because I didn't like it. It was just that I was watching other things at the time. I just wanted to prioritize more, but it was all right. It had some funny bits. I'll put in C. Next one is the Quintessential Quintuplets movie. Now, I was actually really excited for this. Quintessential Quintuplets is one of my favorite romance series, so I had a lot of expectations for it. I felt it sort of rushed the ending, and there's a lot of parts that I felt like were a little unnecessary. After season two, they heavily hinted at who would be the wife, and I feel like they could have, I don't know, it was a little too obvious for me. So I feel like with some parts of the movie, it's like, all right, we know who it's going to be. And then the ending just felt a little rushed. But still was a good conclusion. I'll put an A. Next one is Raven of the Inner Palace. Now, this is one that's a historical series that I was really looking forward to. But they went too romance-y for me. If they stuck with the historical mystery, I think this would have been really good. But I was not looking for a romance in this. So I'll put in C. Next one is Reincarnated as a Sword. This is another one that I need to catch up on, but from what I've seen, I think this is a solid isekai. I like Parallel World Pharmacy and other isekai this year more. I'm going to put it in C for now. All right, we're going to make this actually real fast with the next couple. Rent-A-Girlfriend Season 2, D. Honestly, I could put it in Farming Poop, but I'll put it in D. Requiem of the Rose King, D. Rising of the Shield Hero Season 2, D. Alright, there, that was pretty fast. Those are some D tiers. But next one is certainly not a D tier. Romantic Killer. Romantic Killer is up there with Kaguya-sama Season 3 for being my favorite romance of the year. This anime is awesome. I think the studio in a lot of ways with Bocchi, we're very creative with animating a lot of the scenes, especially with Anzu and Riri, the Riri being the wizard in the series. This is an awesome romance series that also takes a really unique concept that is in a genre that's oversaturated with a lot of the same stuff. And I really appreciate that with Romantic Killer. This is an S tier. Really enjoyed this one. Next one is Sabuki Bisco. This is the Mushroom Hunter one. This one is solid. I'm going to just be frank with it. It's a C. It's not D, but it was just solid. Solid seasonal, but one that I won't remember. Next one is Shadows House Season 2. Now, I really like Shadows House Season 1, and Season 2 did a really great job as well. I feel like the first two episodes started off a little slow, but then it really picked up and really picked up on some of the mystery elements very well. Shadows House Season 2, I'm putting in A tier. Really liked it. Next one is Shikimori's Not Just a Cutie. I can't believe I finished this series. Yes, I watched it and finished it, and this series is not good. The main character is atrocious. He honestly shouldn't even be alive. He can't even live by himself or alone without somebody helping him. And I think Shikimori is a solid character, but my goodness, I could not stand the main character in this series in general. This is a D tier. Next one is Skeleton Knight from Another World. This is another isekai and one that is solid. I'll give it to it. But it doesn't really make any strides for anything that's unique in the genre. It's very solid, though. I will put it in C tier. All right, next one. Spy X Family. And this is encompassing Spy X Family and Spy X Family Part 2. This is, without a doubt, a masterpiece. Spy X Family is one of the best series going on right now. And the manga is amazing. I read it, and I'm almost up to date with it. And the anime's done an amazing job. It cemented Anya as one of the best characters of the year. The comedy is amazing. The overall just enjoyment factor and feel-good aspect of the series, it's one of the best. It's one of the best of the year for sure. Masterpiece. Next one is Summertime Render. This one really caught me off guard. This one is an S tier. It's a mystery psychological series, sort of a blend between Higurashi and ReZero. I love the whole story of this. This is one that I was a little worried that the mystery would be revealed and done with after like episode 6. And they found a way to really continue engaging the audience with the story for 25 episodes. I loved this series. It was, at the time, the series I was most looking forward to every week to watch. Summertime Render, if you haven't seen it. If you haven't seen it, certainly go check it out. Next one is Eminence in Shadow. This is one that I'm watching right now this season. It's another isekai, but essentially it's like an isekai parody. But I'm really enjoying this one right now. It's one I'm looking forward to every week. It's very entertaining. I think it's very funny. I think the main character is a lot of jokes. I'm going to put in A tier actually right now. All right, next one is To Your Eternity Season 2. This is one that I was super anticipating. To Your Eternity was my favorite anime of last year. So I had a lot of expectations for Season 2. And they are not delivering right now. I'm going to be honest. They are not delivering. I'm going to put this in A tier. Season 1 would have been a masterpiece. And I really want it to be higher, but I'm going to put it in A tier. Next one is Tomodachi Game. Now, Tomodachi Game, I read the manga for, actually, after watching this series, because I think the concept's great. It's very much like Squid Game, but kind of in a twisted different way. And Yuichi Katagiri is an amazing main character. But I think the anime in this first few arcs covered some okay stuff. I'm going to put it B tier. The ending of it isn't. I wasn't the biggest fan of. But that arc in general in the manga, I just wasn't the biggest fan of. But if it gets a season 2, the next few arcs are going to be awesome. I will say. So really, really be on the lookout for Season 2, because Tomodachi Game could actually blow up after Season 2. But Yuichi Katagiri, the main character, phenomenal. Great main character. Next one, I'm going to butcher the title, but it's Trapped in an Atome Game. I don't remember what else goes after that, but it's Trapped in an Atome Game. This is another one that I really enjoyed. It's between A and B for sure. Leon Fobartfort is amazing. He's so trolly. But a lot of the other characters I really couldn't care for. The Queen, and I think there was like a robot. I'm blanking so hard. They were entertaining, but the comedy is good. The other characters are all right. I'm going to put it B, though. Definitely between B and A, though. Next one is Uncle from Another World. Now, this one got delayed for so long. So I've only seen, I think, 7 episodes as of now, maybe 8. And of those 8, it is an A tier. It is so funny. I love the concept of this. This is an isekai concept that was done right and executed right. It didn't just have an amazing concept and that was it, but it had an amazing concept and the anime really delivered on those expectations every single episode. Every single episode, I am laughing. I'm enjoying myself. I think it's so good. I think the contrast between them in the real world, between how he was in the isekai world, so good. Love it. All right, 3 series left. Wow, we started flying by. Urusei Yatsura. Urusei Yatsura is a remake of a 1980 anime series, and I'm really enjoying this. This is another one that I think the comedy is really good. This is an A tier. I am really enjoying this. All right, 2 left. Ya boy Kong Ming. Yes, ya boy Kong Ming. This is one that caught me off guard in the spring season, and I told everyone about it because the opening is phenomenal, and Kong Ming, just in general, is just such a funny character. I love it. Very entertaining. The music is great. I still listen to a lot of the soundtrack on Spotify from Aiko. So I really enjoy this series. I'm putting in A tier. And last series is Yakuza Guide to Babysitting. This is one that was solid. I enjoyed it. The girl that the main Yakuza guy was babysitting, I thought was very cute. This is a very feel-good anime. I'm going to put it in B tier. And that is it for the tier list, ladies and gentlemen. So I had 5 in Masterpiece, working my way down. A lot of A's and B's, but makes sense. I typically only try to watch the good anime, I'd say, of the year, or the ones that are recommended to me. So I try not to watch some of the bad stuff, but obviously it ends up happening. Pretty much all of these I didn't finish, except Chikamori, which I don't know why. And then there's this. There's Farming Poop. But that is it for the video, everybody. Let me know what I got right and wrong in the comments and what your guys' favorite anime of the years are. Or what your least favorite anime of the year is. Just let me know in the comments. And if you enjoyed the video, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Because it really does mean a lot to me. I am Tiago with Attack on Tiago, and I hope you all have a nice day.